When I was a child, I used to lay in bed late at night, staring at the ceiling, listening to my father scream. Scream at my mother, scream at yet another failed masterpiece. Finally, just scream out into the darkness. It became my lullaby. And even when they took me away, the screams followed. I was once told that insanity runs in my family. It's time to make it stop.
I wonder when was the last time this place saw sunlight. This place is a mess.
I can hear you in there. I'm coming, you furry little bastards. You're not getting away this time. Oh, where did I put that damn key?
Ugh, it reeks in here.
I swear, that dog doesn't shut up! Go on, get out of here! Before I find a way to keep you in there for good!
Thank you.
not how it went. Maybe... What is that? Yes! That's it!
What's wrong with this thing? Huh. I don't remember that being there. I can hear you out there! Please, please help me. It hurts. Oh, it hurts so much. I can't take it anymore. Yes. Thank you. It's so good to feel that there's still beauty in this world.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark. And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something...
Keep your head straight!
As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye. And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end of her. And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end of her. The princess heard a fearsome growl. The witch had unleashed her.
As the princess moved, the growl got louder.
The witch had unleashed her familiar, the hellhound. The monster sniffed at the air, its perky ears wary of even the slightest sound. The princess remained motionless, letting the monster pass. There was a stillness in the air. The princess breathed a sigh of relief. For a moment, it seemed like the worst was behind her, and yet she knew that it was not over. There was still danger nearby, waiting for her slightest move. Frozen in terror, she kept looking straight ahead. Suddenly, she heard a terrifying cackle. It was the evil witch herself. The wretched thing despised beauty and innocence, for she had neither. The hag was near, just outside of view, but our heroine didn't dare to look. She had to keep her head straight, lest she be cursed by the witch's foul magic. She could almost feel the chilling touch of the witch's hand at her neck. She felt a sudden urge to run away. She felt the sudden urge to run away, but fought it with all her will, for she knew that was precisely what the witch would have wanted. And then, just like that, the chill was gone. She saw a glimmer of light over the horizon. The sun was almost upon her. It was almost dawn. It was almost over. And there, the princess stood triumphant in the sun, smiling as she... Wait, that's not right. Her face, why is she still scared? Oh, God. I didn't mean to... Princess, I am so sorry.
It's not that he was cruel. It's just that, to him, reality was just a pale reflection of art. He was blind to the world, unless it was translated to him through a canvas.
Dog better not be where I think it is.
Oh, hey there, princess. You want to sit on Daddy's lap? Come on, it's okay.
Thank you.
Hey there. Oh, come on, don't be afraid. It won't bite. Here, try for yourself. No, that's not quite right. Huh, still not quite there.
Whoever's pounding on that piano, quit it!
You know what? I have an idea. Go get your crayons.
That's actually not bad.
Look at you, young lady. It looks like talent runs in the family.
Help! Wasn't my fault. You can't hold me responsible. No one could have seen it coming. What's done is done. It's not like I can undo any of it. There's no point in dwelling on the past. It's better to forget. Shut it out. Lock it away.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, Princess, don't sneak up on me like that. Especially when I'm working. So, what do you think? Oh, you like it? Well, that makes one of us.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear.
Are you out of your mind?
What? You said there was gonna be a party. I just started a bit early.
Whoops.
Are you out of your mind?
What? You said there was gonna be a party. I just started a bit early.
Whoops.
This one's gonna be perfect. It has to be. I'm gonna prove it. All of you. What? Not now, Princess. Go play with your dollies, or your crayons. Daddy's very busy.
Well, that makes it all better, doesn't it? It'll just magically unbreak because you didn't mean to. Go on, get out of here. Go to your room and break shit in there. Just take all your toys and smash them one by one. And keep at it. Maybe you'll finally get good at something.
sick! You're insane! You're not thinking straight!
You're right! I am sick! I'm sick of you not being there for us! We need you. I need you. What was the last time you said you didn't want to? In there for hours, days. You come out looking like shit, stinking of booze and stale piss. What? Oh, that's all right, honey. Something got into Mommy's eye, that's all. You be a good little girl and go to sleep. Daddy's working, so we can't disturb him. Mommy has to go downstairs and take a bath. I love you. More than a wife, she was first and foremost his muse. Her beauty and talent drove him. After the accident, she became a burden, a disgusting monster screeching out from her bed, an anchor weighing him down.
still alive.
What are you doing? Put that down! You're much too old for that childish nonsense.
Thank you.
little girl in red was walking through the woods, when suddenly, out of nowhere, jumped out you-know-who. Eyes glowing bloody red, teeth sharp as razors. And yet the big bad wolf did not seem to faze her. "Be careful, little girl," the big bad wolf sneered. "You're in Fantasyland, where things ain't what they seem." "Oh, shush, you big old meanie," the frightened girl exclaimed. "You're the only threat in this wonderful land. With my magic crayons, I can do no harm. I can make the trees yellow, turn them upside down, turn grass into candy, make the sky go red. I can do whatever pops into my head." The wolf was unimpressed with his show of skill. "You do have the power to do what you will. Alas, I humbly urge you to practice restraint, for you are responsible for what you create." "You're nasty, jealous, and mean," said the little girl. "I just want to have fun, and you want me to learn. I wish a big old rock would fall down from the sky and crush your big bad mouth into a mincemeat pie." "Don't do it, I beg you," the big wolf cried. "You lack scale and perspective, my sweet little child." But it was too late. His warning fell on deaf ears. Down came the rock and smashed them all to smithereens.
Creativity is not a toy, it's a gift. Do you want to squander it like all those careless brats out there?
The little girl in red came upon a crossroads. There she stopped and wondered, which way should I go? Up jumped the wolf and gave the poor girl a fright. Do not be afraid, I'm not gonna bite. One of these paths with danger is fraught, while the other one, most assuredly, is not. The little girl in red took a shortcut she knew, through a lovely field of corn, all covered in dew. But the field grew dark and full of despair, and an eerie sense of dread filled the morning air. The girl heard the wolf yelling from afar, "You have chosen poorly, you will not get far. Had you only learned how shadow and light intertwined on canvas, you could have chosen right." The little girl in red ran as fast as she could, her flowing dark hair tucked under her hood. But she quickly got tired, worn out by her flight, and succumbed to the darkness, never to see the light.
Are you trying to annoy me? This is not what I've taught you.
What? You think I'm enjoying this? You think I'm doing this out of spite? Get it right next time and I won't have to fix it for you!
You're doing this on purpose, aren't you?
There! I hope you're satisfied with yourself! Stop crying! We'll pick this up tomorrow, and I swear to God, I better start seeing some progress!
Looking back, I don't think my father ever really wanted a child. It's no wonder I was never truly allowed to be one. No, no, what he wanted, above all things, was a successor. Someone to carry on his legacy. Anything else was just a distraction. I don't know what I expected to find. A farewell note? A final will? What I found was an apology. Expressed in the only language he ever truly knew. At that moment, I could finally see my father for what he was. A man driven insane with sadness and guilt. Trapped in this house, a nightmarish echo chamber of past mistakes and tragedies. It was this house, a place beyond hope, beyond redemption. I knew what I had to do. I had given up trying to understand my father a long time ago. But I could finally forgive him. Hey, Princess. What have you got there? Oh, that's so lovely, sweetie. But why pink?